Alright, we are back again. Hold on, let me get the camera angled straight. Best we can. You know who it is. It's the 10th again. July, no, not the 10th. July the 20th. This month is flown by. Yeah. This seemed like the 4th of July was just the other day.
Yeah.
July the 20th, Matt and Jeremy. And we just completed our 1 hour segment. We were testing the BlackBerry PGP format video camera here. They're cutting grass outside. I don't know how loud it's going to be on the tape. Hopefully it's not loud. But
yeah, hopefully not too loud.
But we started at 2:40 here. But we're doing our best to keep a careful list, again, like we said earlier, of what's in each video. So we don't have any more problems with trying to type each one on YouTube. We had a lot of problems with that when I gave up on Facebook, as I said earlier. Hold on, I think this camera looks a little off on the alignment. Let me just double check. Just so it's done. Yeah, it is a little bit. It's at the wrong angle. There we go. Alright, now we're ready. I'm a perfectionist. I tend to be like that.
You need a perfectionist.
I'm very picky on my videos, so on video quality. See, we have Lord Buddha accompanying us here. Several Lord Buddhas. Is that Christ or that Buddha too?
It's Bodhisattva.
Okay.
Some of the protection line.
And the candle burning. Alright. Anyway, like, well, we didn't know how long the video, each video could be on this. I got a 2 gig memory card plus a gig onboard memory. That's 3. And a 1 hour video takes up 174 megs on a 3GP format file, and the limit is 59 minutes, 59 seconds. And we found that out just in time. We were kept on talking a couple minutes after. And then realize, oh shit, it is 1 hour. At least we know. But this one won't be an hour, but we're going to talk. We have more to talk about. But we want to say that we really welcome people calling us more. We want to hear more from y'all. Please write more questions. Call.
Yeah.
Don't be afraid to pick those telephones up. Don't be afraid to pick those keyboards up and type something out and send it to us.
Yeah.
You know, ask us a question. Even if it seems like silly almost to you, but that you worry that we're going to think it's stupid or silly.
Right.
As you ask something like that, go ahead and ask it anyway.
Yeah, we'd like to try to touch on those subjects, you know, especially, you know, if you ask questions, we want to answer them for you.
That's right. And another thing is on this, you know, don't be afraid to ask us for help either. You know, like, I think most of y'all know by now that we don't charge. Unlike 99.9999% or more of medium psychics, spiritual educators out there, we don't charge. You know, like, we squeak by right now. We're getting by, but we're doing what we love. This is what we love to do, is help and
help people.
If we're not doing this, if I was stuck doing some job I hated, I would take my own life. If I had no other choice than to do that, I would. You know, nothing, because that would not make me happy. I despise every day of my life. That's what I was forced to do.
Yeah.
I would blow my brains out, to be honest with you. If someone said, no, from now on to the day you die, you're working as a cashier in a grocery store. You know, and you can never do spiritual teaching or ever think about it. I'm going home, and I'm going to blow my brains out.
Well, some people, of course, like to work as cashiers.
Some people enjoy that, but not me.
Yeah, but not, you know, not us in these situations. But
it's our destiny to do this, so we're going to do it.
Yeah, yes, and we don't, like you said, we don't charge anything, so it's not like we're not there to help. We're here to help. We're at your disposal, you know, let's get something going here.
And the no charge thing, I think, should I think that's going to eliminate a lot of questions about our motives. I know it does.
Right, right.
You know, about if we're legit or not, or if we're just in it for the money. You know, because a lot of people be like, why wouldn't they be legit? You know, they're not charging a penny. Why would somebody who's fake, you know, sitting here saying, we're not charging anything and living here just squeaking by, just and doing only this? What's the point of somebody faking? Why would we be faking? Believe me, we're not faking a thing. You know, of course, we have more balls than some of these mediums and psychics out there. No offense to any of you guys, but we do have more balls. You know, we speak about things before other people even ask. Like, you know, you hear us talking about people that died on the news, talking about the news that happened this morning. And then we're here just openly saying, look, we've been talking with the spirits of this person and that person, and we have.
Yeah.
And let me assure you that we have. You know, and that we do this every day. You know, it doesn't have to be in Richmond. You know, we, like you said, I talk to, I have a lot, it gives me a lot of pleasure to talk to the Bloods and the Crips from South Central LA, the ones that are crossed over. And I really enjoy that, talking to prison gangs, that people crossed over from prison gangs who were killed in prison. Mm-hmm. It gives me a lot of pleasure and enjoyment to be friends with them, you know, to form friendships with them.
Absolutely.
Because they're beautiful people, beautiful souls, too.
Sure,
absolutely. You know, some of my best friends in the spirit world are our Blood and Crips, actually. I can say that, too. You know, among some other gangs that aren't as well known, like that dude Jay, or whatever his name was, Jay from that Wets dude, Chicago West Side Wets. He died in like 1983 or 1984 in West Side Chicago. Yeah. But he had a gang. His gang set was called the West Side Wets. You know, that's what it was, the Wets. And then I think if you were wet, if you had killed somebody or if you'd done something, you know what I'm saying? Like, that's when you were wet, you know? You know, you're officially a wet once you were wet. Well, I guess they meant wet with blood, you know?
Yeah.
That's what they meant, you know? This guy was such a great dude, man. There's a video on YouTube of him coming through. You know, this happened last fall when we met him. This dude, Jay, is so great, man. Real, real intelligent brother.
Yeah.
So nice, man. You know, and he learned a lot from his gangbanging life. You know, he killed people, done crazy things, but yet, you know, there was no dinosaur flapping devil down there, dinosaur tail flapping devil torturing them, you know, with horns, you know, for him killing people. He was living a great life, happiness and forgiven, and he didn't have to ask Christ for it or accept Christ as a savior and to do that. You can, but, you know, everybody's forgiven, even Christ himself. You sat down and talked to him. Yeah, I think even Christ, I can guarantee you he would say something along those lines.
Right.
That you don't have to come to me for forgiveness. Forgive yourself. I got a feeling that he would say something like that.
Yeah, and Christ is going straight to the infinite to get his forgiveness. Yeah.
That's right.
You know, and that's all you have to do too, really.
Go to the infinite. Yeah. You can go to the infinite yourself. I mean, or you forgive yourself.
Yeah,
Because you're a God anyway, so as a God, it's your responsibility to yourself to forgive yourself.
Very important. Very important to getting through a lot in life is to forgive yourself and the people that you feel like you can't forgive. Spend time working on forgiving them. Move forward and show some love and compassion. Handle this situation with care, you know, do the best you can because, you know, you are a walking God, you know, what you express and what you do will always be what you express and what you do, so it's up to you, and how you want to handle these things, but know that you are a very powerful human being in yourself.
That's correct, well, the human being part is only a little bit of a little mannequin thing, a little costume, but it's the soul, the spirit within, that's